There are so many different areas of our profession that students get exposed to here in their classes. Do you guys know who you're fingerprinting? Are you fingerprinting yourself or a partner? Okay, good. Hi, my name's Pricilla Doyle, and I am an adjunct instructor at FSW, teaching classes in forensic death investigation, intro to forensic science, and crime scene in the crime scene and criminal justice programs. Right now, objective number one is to ink your 10 card. It's not like TV. It's not like you solve crimes in 45 minutes and, you know, case closed and the judge bangs the gavel. The object is to get from the first crease, underneath the first crease of your finger, and you're gonna roll. So you're gonna go from the side all the way over to the other side. In the advanced crime scene, they'll process a scene almost a semester long. So they have to do everything from the initial investigation of the scene and the search warrant to the complete resolution of the scene and the preparation of their case for court. So it's really walking through a whole crime from start to finish. That's a really great experience and educational experience to have because it prepares you for court. It prepares you for trial testimony, which really you don't get that experience anywhere else. So watch what we do. Okay. You're gonna roll. Crime Scene Island is great because we can have mock human remains that are buried that need to be excavated, which is also a lot of fun and an experience that not a lot of people get to have. We have a lot. We have a lot of resources. We have a lot of really quality faculty, and I think our program is stellar. Okay, so for those of you who are done inking your 10 card, now we're gonna move on to the fun and the potential really messy part of the day. It's a puzzle, and I love to solve puzzles. It's the world's greatest puzzle because you're presented with so many challenges, no 2 days are ever the same, and you get to really critically think and use not just your education, your training and skills, but your common sense and your curiosity to keep looking for answers. And then you wanna very gently dust the area where you just left your print. See what's gonna happen? You can see it already. Remember, a little goes a long way. I teach Intro to Crime Scene, which is an introductory course for generally the first or second semester student who thinks they wanna be in this field, but they're not sure and they want an introduction to it. The next course is usually forensic science, and Intro to Forensic Science gives them a little bit of exposure to the microscope and to the scientific tests behind the evidence that we gather. And then the last class I teach, and my favorite, is forensic death investigation, and that's because that's what I do. And that's a class that focuses on the investigation of death. Okay, did you dust it already? Okay, let me show you. I think that our office has played a role in the successful resolution of a number of cases, but the big cases don't matter. It's the every single day cases. It's the little tiny victories of giving somebody an answer that they really needed to hear, or some closure that they really needed to have on a much smaller scale than you would think. But I think those are the most important victories.
Professor, it's not popping up.
It will. Be patient. Let's see.
Oh, it's right there. It's right there.
So I was a student here in the 80s. Even from back then, it was Edison Community College. You know, it was the place to go. It was the only college here. And even then, there was a feeling on the campus of community, of a family. We were a small town, you know, in the 80s we were a small town. So now, in those same buildings that are changed, and on that same campus that's definitely different, the students who come here are part of our community. They're our family, they're our Southwest Florida family. So I have taught at other institutions and I've enjoyed those experiences teaching at other institutions, but FSW is where it began for me, and it's where I've seen so many students start their successful educational career. Students who are now working for the FBI, students who are now working for Division of Financial Services and Insurance Fraud, students working for the DEA. So this starts a lot of really, really great careers, and it starts in a place where some people think, oh, I'm just gonna go for a couple years and get a degree and we'll see what happens. And then they find these programs and they get this interest and they turn into the leaders, you know, that we've produced from this campus, and that's why FSW.